All people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى يرضى سيدنا محمد. You are on. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزلة، نويت الرياضة، نويت السلوك. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. كنا في الأمس نتكلم عن اسم الله عز وجل المعطي، العطاء، العطاء لا يكون عطاء إذا كان محدودا، بل العطاء الذي لا حد له. والله عز وجل هو المعطي، أي لا حد لعطائه ولا نقصانية أو نقص في خزائنه، فهو الخالق وهو المعطي وهو المانع وهو النافع وهو الضار. او مسلمز مؤمنز، we were speaking yesterday about the meaning of العطاء. العطاء cannot be anyone can give. It's something that he gives, but it has limits from human beings. But from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no limits. We have to establish this first. نتفق على أنه عطاء الله عز وجل غير محدود، وعطاء العبد هو تشبها فقط، ولكن عطاؤه محدود. والعطاء المحدود لا يفي بالغرض، أما العطاء الغير محدود فيفي بالغرض. If you go and visit someone who is rich, he might give you something when you go out from his house as a gift, because he can afford it. Next time you come, he might give you another gift. Third time you come, you begin to see the gift becomes smaller. Less and less. Because he has limits. He cannot keep giving and giving and giving. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives and gives and gives and still giving and non-stopping. For that reason, awliyaullah, they know that reality. Ulama al-Ummah, they know that reality, but also in a limited way. But awliyaullah with no limits, as some of those who are considered as بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون, they are alive in their graves, provided even Allah providing them, as He said in Holy Quran, بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون, He is giving, still giving them from His عطاء. He doesn't stop. Even in the grave He is giving. In Akhirah, giving paradise. Non-stop. Allah gives, we have to take. If we don't take what He is giving, means you are rejecting His generosity. Then you are falling into a big sin. When this majlis, like this majlis, بذكر الصالحين تنزل الرحمة, remembering pious people, rahma will come down. So this, when you are avoiding to get that rahma, you are committing a sin. Like for example, you go and for a generous person, تدخل عند كريم القوم, تجلس عنده, يعطيك من ما أعطاه الله فلا تأخذه, فهذا عيب عليك, مشين لك. You enter into a house of a generous person, he gives you something, you don't take it, that's bad for you, because you cannot reject a gift from a generous person. What you think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator? If He gives you something, you take it. And Allah said in Holy Quran, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ, what Prophet gave, offered you, take it. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what we are doing, we are taking, yeah? Say.
No.
Yeah, we are not. Don't be afraid. We are not. Fahamt? Sheikh Salah? Allah al-Mu'ati. إذا أعطى أدهش. فعليك واجبنا أن نأخذ. لا نقول ما عليش, ما فيش مشكلة. الحمد لله, we have. No. Take. خذ. لذلك يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى, قل يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله, means there is no limits of Allah's mercy. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله means there is no limits of Allah's mercy. Not only to, لا تقنطوا, don't despair Allah's mercy. No, Allah is saying don't, take it, I'm sending, I'm giving it to you. أنا جليس من ذكرني, I'm with you, sitting with you. This garden here is a garden that has no limit, no beginning, no end. فأخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو الصادق المصدوق على أنه في كل مكان يوجد روضة من رياض الجنة. فتعجبت الصحابة, يا رسول الله كيف روضة ما بين قبري ومنبري روضة من رياض الجنة, between my grave and my member a piece of paradise, but how on other hands you are saying that there are everywhere pieces of paradise. هل روضة من رياض الجنة فقط في مكان واحد أو في عدة أمكنة؟ الله ربما بقدرة الله عز وجل يجعل الدنيا كلها روضة من رياض الجنة. لو أقرت العباد بربوبية الحق فعلا بدون إشراك بدون شرك لجعل الأرض كلها روضة من رياض الجنة. والحديث النبوي الشريف قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا مررتم برياض الجنة فارتعوا. When you pass by the gardens of paradise, sit. Don't continue walking, no sit. فارتعوا. الصحابة astonished. يا رسول الله وأين نجد هذه الروضات أو هذه الرياض؟ إذا مررتم برياض الجنة إذا مررتم بهذه الرياض اجلسوا. قالوا: وما رياض الجنة يا رسول الله؟ أين نجد هذا الرياض؟ قال: حلق الذكر. انتهى. لو جلس ثلاثة هنا يذكرون الله لجعل مكانهم روضة من رياض الجنة. If three people sit together here and making ذكر, that moment, that place, that peace become a روضة from رياض الجنة. So that's عطاء الله. No end. When he gives, he gives. يقول حضرة الشيخ مولانا الشيخ عبد الله الفايز الدرستاني إنه لو عبد العبد عبادة الثقلين عبادة الثقلين أي عبادة الإنس والجن من أول الدنيا إلى آخرها ذاك الرجل يعتبر عابد والله يمده ويعطيه من عطائه ويقول لو عبد عبادة أهل السماء وأهل الأرض عند الله عز وجل ذاك الرجل له فضيلة كبرى. If anyone makes عبادة worshipness عبادة الثقلين the worshipness of ins and humans and jinns. If he worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the numbers of human beings and jinn, ibadatu sakalain, Allah will give him. Will give him from his ata ma la aynun ra'at wa la udhunun sami'at wa la khatara ala qalbi bashar. He will give them from his treasures that never ends. Ma la aynun ra'at, not an eye never saw. ولا أذن سمعت ولا and no ears that heard ولا خطر على قلب بشر and never you thought about it. Allah will give and you have to do that. You are ordered to do that. You are obliged to do that. On the other hand, he said, you see the abid, how much Allah give reward, but his ata, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله أي لا تقنطوا من عطاء الله. إن الله غفور رحيم. الله will forgive. So forgive what? Forgive your sin. May Allah bless these awliya that show you the greatness and the love that Allah has given to those who obey Him.
Allahu Akbar.
He said, if a person leave one manhiyun anhu, one forbidden, Allah will reward him ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. To leave one forbidden, because to do worshipness is easy. You sit and you do worshipness. But like someone who goes to army and the enemy is far, he's looking at them, he's I'm shooting, I'm going to shoot you, I'm going to shoot you, I'm going to shoot you. But he's not shooting. Because the enemy is, he knows if he shoot on them, these enemies will come and kill him. But he's saying it by tongue. But at the end, he doesn't get anywhere. When someone wants to forbid himself from committing a sin, four enemies comes on him. Four battalions of Iblis, nafs, dunya, hawa, shaitan. Four enemies: his self, his ego, his desires, dunya, the world. Dunya comes to him, say, no way, I will not let you. Hawa, desire, bad desires, shaitan, evil power. Four enemies will come to stop you, to stop you from committing, to not let you to make a
to stop committing a sin.
They will not let you to stop committing a sin. They want you to commit a sin. They will fight for you. They will give you bad desires in your heart. Fill up your heart with everything possible to avoid leaving that sin. No, they want you to commit that sin. They blow in you the blow of desires, bad desires, to commit a sin. And if you avoid and resist, and you ask forgiveness and you left that sin, Allah will give you what He gives someone who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the worship of jinn and ins. If you combined all together, Allah will reward you for that worshipness, and Allah will reward you for that resisting the four enemies that within you. That's ata'ullah. Arba'at a'da fi kulli insan fi jawfihi fi qalbihi. Hunaka arba'atu a'da yaskunun fi qalbihi. An-nafs wa-dunya والهوى والشيطان. نفسك عدوك. نفس is enemy within you. شيطان is enemy within you. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, I am the only one that I ride on my شيطان. It's not easy. Shaitan is following you to put you in hellfire. Nafs, the self, dunya. All of us, we are running for dunya. It's not. حب الدنيا رأس كل خطيئة. الدنيا جيفة وطلابها كلاب. The dunya is the head of every sin. It is with you, in your hand. Not one person is seeking Allah purely. Most of people seeking dunya purely. Allah seeking you, I will give you from my ata, from my generosity. Why Allah ata comes? إذا كنت حبيبا لله عز وجل أعطاك الله من عطائه. في الدنيا إذا أحببت رجلا أو أحببت امرأة أو أحببت ولدا أو أحببت بيتا, you love something from دنيا, they will give to you. عطاء الله will give you because you are loving what he said in Holy Quran, وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه, whatever prophet gave to you, take it. When you follow that way, Allah will come to you. في الحديث القدسي, من جاءني مهرولا جئته, من جاءني ماشيا جئته مهرولا. Anyone approaches me one hand, I will come him one arm. If he comes to me walking, I come to him running. Means don't commit the sin from by believing and accepting these four enemies: dunya, nafs, dunya, hawa, desires, and shaitan. They are within us. That's our problem. How to eliminate that power? These four enemies. Not machine guns. Machine guns easy. Might be rockets. From within you to commit a sin. Sayyidina Yusuf was nearly going to fall into the test. But by Zulaikha, the wife of the king of Egypt, Allah saved him because he said, Ya Rabbi, if you are not supporting me, I am falling. Allah saved him. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul. Amen. He said a story, but I don't know if I can say that story. He said that there was someone in his village he committed a sin, and that sin was enough to take that person in the wrong direction, and it was a way for Iblis to blow in that person شهوات خمسون رجل.
The desire for ladies,
50
men.
The desire for ladies, the power of 50 men. He blew in him to sleep with a lady. And then he said, Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, that was the story of that man to the Sheikh. He said, I felt myself, something came within me, gave me power so big that I want to go into haram. Allah I turned, Ya Rabbi. That's my problem. I am asking forgiveness. He said, when as soon as he said that, his thumb burst. And his semen, correct, came out from his thumb with blood. And that shahwa, desire, went down. And he didn't do haram. He said, that person, I know him very well. He doesn't do anything without telling me. He came to me afraid, frightened, telling me that what happened to him. Shaitan, when he comes through a person, will take over. That's why we have to be very careful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all that, Allah saved him. Because what he did? Istighfar. Ata'ullah la yantahi. Allah's ata never ends. Because if you are looking for him, he's looking for you. مازال عبد يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. As long as my servant approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I will love him. Allah is saying, I will love him. Means now, Allah loves us or no? We don't know. Because we are not fully doing well in our worshipness. He said, مازال عبدي, مازال, I continuously يتقرب إلي بالنوافل. I continuously approaches me through voluntary worshipness بالنوافل. I will love him because he is dedicating himself for me. So dedicate yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will be seeking you, looking for you. Come. I sit with you, he said. Is that? أنا جالس من ذكرني. I will sit with you. What I will sit with you? Like you sitting with me? Means I will give you whatever you want. I will dress you from my rahmah. Ask anything, I will give. I will not put you down. You are my sincere servant. Today, we are running away. Killing for no reason. Shouting, screaming, fighting for no reason. You want to do good? Kill your desires within you. Then you are coming. Because when you have no desires, you will not commit a sin. One story that can come with this, that Sayyidina Abu Yazid al-Bastami, when he was approaching, worshipping in full power, in full worshipness, asking, Ya Rabbi, open for me, let me enter into the your garden, the garden of heavens, heavenly garden. And he heard, when he was asking and asking and asking, he heard, اترك نفسك وتعال. Leave yourself and come. My door is open. You cannot enter with yourself. Both of you, you cannot go inside. Leave yourself. Yourself cannot be in my gardens. Leave it and welcome. قال انسلخت من جلدي كما تنسلخ الحية من جلدها. As a snake, how it skin itself from its skin, peels itself from the skin, I peeled myself from my skin and came to the door. And I heard a voice, Ya Abba Yazid, come inside. In my gardens that Prophet has mentioned, Riyadh al-Jannah. And Grand Sheikh say that why ibadatu al-sakalain, the one who leave, the worshipper who do ibadatu al-sakalain, worshipness of the two power jinn and ins, he worship, still the one who leaves one forbidden, one sin, Allah will give him like he is giving the other one. Because to leave the sin is difficult, as we said. What Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? Allahumma la takinni ila nafsi tarfat aynin wa la aqalla min dalik. O Allah, don't leave me to myself for a blink of an eye. Right? Prophet is worshipper, not ibadatu sakalain. عبادة كل العباد من الملائكة إلى الإنسان إلى الجن إلى الحيوانات كل من يسبح ويذكر الله عز وجل فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر ويسبح أعلى من الجميع ومع ذلك يقول يا ربي لا تكني إلى نفسي طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك Don't leave me to my ego for a blink of an eye. If Prophet says that, don't leave me to my ego for a blink of an eye, are we safe from that? We are fully diving in our ego. So if Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, Ya Rabbi, don't leave me to depend on my worshipness for a blink of an eye. Because Allah, if He wants, وَجِئْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَّنثُورًا. We come to what they have done, then we throw it in their faces. So Prophet is saying, I cannot depend on my amal. So how we can depend on our amal? But we can depend on asking forgiveness. That's why daily our awliya Allah or ulama or scholars or whatever, they ask you and they recommend to you and advise to you to say istighfar in order that Allah will forgive. If Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is asking, Ya Rabbi, don't leave me to myself, how we can say to ourselves, we are leaning on you? No. We are leaning on our worshipness. No. We are leaning on Ata'ullah, Rahmatullah, Hubbullah. That's what we are leaning on. Hubbun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hubbun Nabi.
Hubbun Nabi والآل ديني ومذهبي حقا ويقيني حب النبي والآل ديني ومذهبي حقا ويقيني وعمدتي في كل حين دوما فإني لا
If you, if how many of ascetics, zuhada, جاءوا وانتقروا يقول مولانا الشيخ عبد الله قدس الله سره How many of zuhad they came and they left dunya? If we bring all their prayers and we added it together, means in the past they came, they were born, they were pious, they were sincere, they prayed, they died. Allah will give them from His endless treasures. But one person now in this time, this was 1388, year 1388, yani 40 years 50 years, whatever. Allah opened because too much fitna. 1388, say He's saying too much fitna. Allah opened the Ummat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rahmatun wasi'a. لو عاصٍ استغفر ربه وطلب المغفرة. If one sinner ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this time because of too much rahmah coming on the ummah ummatun nabi, too much fitna, so Allah sent too much rahmah to balance. If one person leave one forbidden, Allah will give you, will give him what He gave all these zuhad ascetics in their lives. To leave one forbidden. لو ترك منهي عنه واحدة لأعطاه الله جميع ما أعطى هؤلاء الزهاد بترك معصية واحدة. أولياء الله. الله فتح على عيونهم كشف لهم. If one person will do that worshipness in this time, not obligations, obligations you have to do it. We are not speaking about obligations. And left one forbidden, although he does his obligation, fasting, praying, zakat, hajj, shahada, tawheed. But on the other hand, there are people who fast, who make tawheed, make zikrullah, fast Ramadan, but still they might do sin, isn't it? And they must ask forgiveness. If one of these people ask forgiveness in this time, Allah will give him like what He gave all these zuhad in all their lives. Yani, no one, no limit of what Allah will give. Because you are seeking his forgiveness, He will reward you. He is seeking you by reward and by His treasures. O Muslims, Ummatun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حب الدنيا رأس كل خطيئة. The love of dunya is the head of every sin. And you are, mashallah, young ones. Still you can have time to ask forgiveness. And we are old. We don't know when we go. But don't forget us from reading for us on our graves Fatiha. Inshallah. We read for each other. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Iqra'u Yasin ala mawtakum." Recite Yasin for your deceased people. Yasin Kalbul Quran means Prophet is giving you the heart, the clean heart. When you read Yasin on a dead person, you are giving him a clean heart, like they do today. What's it? Heart transplant. So Allah giving you a pure heart whenever you recite Yasin. Allah will give you as alive and give that deceased for him also one. You read two Yasin, two hearts. Every day Yasin, every day new heart. But ask. We don't know. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and bless us and keep us at the footsteps of Awliya Allah.
Ameen.
Bihurmat al-Habib, bihurmat al-Fatiha. This 50 years ago, Allah opened that tajalli, too much fitna. Sayyidina Imam Shafi'i, when he was in Baghdad, he wrote his school of thought, Mazhab al-Imam al-Shafi'i, according to the environment and the conditions that was in Baghdad. When he went to Egypt, he found too much corruption, too much people are making sin. So he changed his Mazhab to a very more strict Mazhab. And Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal more strict also his Mazhab as time passed. What do you think about now? That 300 years from Hijrah, Imam Shafi'i. 300 years from Hijrah, he was at that time very famous, big scholar. 300 Hijri. He changed his Mazhab around that time. No. And now it is 1437. What you expect is not like in the time of Sayyidina Shafi'i. So fitna now today is more. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, said, and Grand Sheikh is not is someone that didn't read physics or chemistry or secular sciences and secular studies. He said one time that from too much fitna, Allah was preventing from a type of jinn, one group of jinn, to attack on human being. Allah was imprisoning them, putting them, that they, not allowing them to come to dunya. But he said, but now they found a way to come to dunya. That's what we are seeing today, a lot of fitna. And that way that they found is a hole through the earth, through the atmosphere, the black holes which you know in physics. Maulana didn't study physics. He said that they found that hole that they can come to earth from the atmosphere through that hole. And he said it is not one hole. Many. And the skies before were sealed with nuts and drops. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْحُبُكِ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والذاريات ذروا فالحاملات وقرا فالجاريات يسرا فالمقسمات أمرا إنما توعدون لصادق وإن الدين لواقع والسماء ذات الحبك.
ذات الحبك means that it has not. This 50 years Grand Sheikh is saying that they didn't discover that except recently. They were using, they say, one hole. There is one hole on from the atmosphere to the earth that they can come. But it is Grand Sheikh said there are too many holes, and the skies were sealed with ropes and knots. Not before they were, say, seven of them.
Strings.
Now, infinite number of strings. How? This is physics. And they found this is true, correct?
Strings.
String field?
Theory.
String theory. They found holes to come from the atmosphere to the earth. And that's what you are seeing this fitna. He said that's going to grow and grow and grow and become bigger and bigger and bigger, that there will be bloodshed on earth. And this will be one sign of the last days, sign of last days. May Allah protect Muslims and humanity, human beings, whatever they are. People are innocent, they are killing innocent people. May Allah forgive all of us and give peace, send peace on earth from this killing. بحرمه الحبيب بحرمه الفاتحه. بعد ثلاثه.